So now we are going to discuss about string gauge allowance. So how to find the string gauge allowance? What is string gauge allowance? First you go to see. As we discuss in the compound cylinders, we want to fit the cylinder at this portion. Here we have a hollow cylinder. We want to fix this here. So assume that the diameter R2 is equal to 251 millimeters. This R2 is, this inner diameter is, here outer diameter, here inner diameter is 249. If you fix this cylinder here, it is possible. Now it is not possible. So you heat this, So now the 249 will be more than 251, Now you can fit this cylinder here. If you fix the cylinder after cooling, what will happen is this diameter already increased to about 251. When it is cooling, it will try to come to 249, but it cannot come because already this cylinder is inside. So that diameter is 251. So there is a force will be acting. Here there is a upward force. Here there is a force like this. Here a force like this. So this 251 will become 250, a common diameter. Here this 249 also will be 250. Slightly it will be increased by 250. So as a compromise, the final dimension will be 250. The common diameter will be 250. So that is this diameter. What happened is, in the outer cylinder, in the outer cylinder, 249 become 250. So here there is a 1 mm. This is a common diameter. So initial diameter of the big cylinder is this. The outer cylinder is this. So this is increased by 1 mm. Similarly, the outer, this is inner cylinder. That diameter is reduced by 1 mm. Some amount. Let us take this is delta naught. There is increase in diameter of the outer cylinder. That is delta R naught. Similarly, reduction in diameter of inner cylinder is delta RI. So now, what is string gauge allowance? String gauge allowance is, that is delta R is equal to delta RI plus delta R naught. This is a string gauge allowance. Now, our objective is, if you want to produce a junction pressure, what should be the value of delta R? That is you have to calculate. Delta RI is the decrease in diameter of the inner cylinder. Delta R naught is the increase in diameter of the outer cylinder. Both you have to calculate. If you calculate, one is diameter is increasing, that you will get positive value. The decrease in diameter, that you will get negative value. But however, we want the total difference. So you don't put minus, you put plus itself. So you add both. However it is minus, you add both. Then only you will get this distance. This is the string gauge allowance that we want to calculate. So to calculate this, what we are going to do is, we are going to calculate the strain. In two terms. So here, if you consider the inner cylinder, the inner cylinder means this portion. There will be a radial stress. As well as there will be a circumferential stress. What is the, what is the strain? If you take strain, this is inner cylinder. So that is the change, because of diameter is delta RI. For inner cylinder, we are taking delta RI. So the strain is equal to delta RI by R2. This junction radius is R2. So delta RI by R2, this is a strain. What strain? In the inner cylinder at the outer radius. The strain is equal to delta RI by R2. What is RI? RI, delta RI, that is reduction in diameter here, and this is R2. This is R2. So delta Ri by R2 is equal to, in terms of stress, if you write, in terms of stress, if you write, that is circumferential stress divided by E minus mu into radial stress, that is sigma R by E. This is the equation. Now you have to see if both are you have to see the nature of stress also, which is tensile, which is compressive. When this is subjected to external pressure, when it is subjected to external pressure, in this case sigma C is also compressive, sigma R also compressive, both are compressive. Then you can take like this, then you can take like this, no problem. So now we are going to take, this is, let us take this inner cylinder. Similarly, in this cylinder, in this outer cylinder, we are going to find strain at this location. We are going to find strain at this location. That is, here in this case, the diameter is increased. Diameter is, this diameter is increased to this diameter. That is delta R naught. Then strain in the outer cylinder is equal to delta R naught by R2. Here also the radius is R2. The radius is R2. Here this diameter, increase in diameter is delta R naught. Here reduction in diameter is delta Ri. So delta Ri by R2. Here delta R naught by R2. This is a strain in the outer cylinder. That you can, so if this is delta C, this is inner cylinder. This is, we can say it is a inner cylinder. So here you have to put outer cylinder. Sigma C outer. Sigma C outer. Sigma C outer divided by E. Here minus, whether it is minus or plus, because in case of outer cylinder, when it is subjected to internal pressure due to junction pressure, the sigma C will be plus, but sigma R will be minus. Sigma R will be minus. Then here you put minus of minus plus, minus of minus plus. That is equal to mu into sigma R by E, sigma R by E. So this is the thing. So if you want to calculate sigma Ri plus sigma R naught, if you want to calculate sigma Ri plus sigma R naught, you add these two equations. Add these two equations. What you will get if you add both delta Ri plus delta R naught divided by R2. If you add these two equations, this plus delta C, sigma C outer, sigma C outer divided by E minus mu into sigma R by E plus sigma C inner divided by E minus, minus no, plus mu into sigma R by E. If you cancel this and this, you will get equation like this. Delta Ri plus delta R naught divided by R2 is equal to, this is equal to sigma C outer by E plus sigma C inner divided by E. So this is equal to what? String gauge allowance. So you can write delta R, string gauge allowance, is equal to, within bracket, you can take, this is R2 by E. R2 by E. R2 means what? Junction radius. Sigma C outer. Sigma C outer plus sigma C inner. So this is the equation. By using this equation, you will be able to find the value of string gauge allowance. String gauge allowance you can calculate delta. This is a way you have to calculate. So now we'll solve one problem. So this is a problem. This is a problem. In this problem, a compound cylinder of inner diameter 200 millimeter, outer diameter 300 millimeter, and junction diameter at 250 millimeter is required. If the radial pressure at junction is to be kept at 30 newton per millimeter square, So a compound cylinder of inner diameter 200 millimeter, outer diameter 300 millimeter, and diameter at junction 250 millimeter is required. If the radial pressure at junction is to be kept 30 newton per millimeter square, find the stringage elements. We want to produce a junction pressure of 30 newton per millimeter square. Then what should be the stringage elements we have to give? What should be the stringage elements you have to give? Young's modulus also given. Young's modulus also given. Now what you have to do is, this is the compound cylinder. This is a compound cylinder. Now this diameter is how much? This is inner diameter is 200. So it is radius is 100. Let us take this is 100. And this is 125. This is 125. And this is 150. 150. And junction pressure. At the junction, the pressure is how much? Junction pressure is PJ. We can say junction pressure is 30. 30 newton per millimeter square. Now what you have to do? Now you are taking only the inner cylinder. Inner cylinder. If you take the inner cylinder, what is the boundary condition? The boundary condition is, in case of inner cylinder, it is subjected to the junction bridge is going to be the outer pressure at the outer diameter. What is the outer diameter? When R is equal to 125, sigma R is equal to how much? 30. This is first boundary condition. What's the next boundary condition? At the inner diameter, when R is equal to 100, sigma R is equal to 0. This is another boundary condition. So now what are the equation? The radial stress equation, 30 is equal to B by 125 square minus A. This is equation. Let us take this is B1, A1. This is equation 1. Now 0 is equal to B1 by 100 square minus A1. This is equation 2. If you solve these two, you will get B1 and A1. B1 and A1. What is the value of B1? It is minus, this is a value, 853 minus 8, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5.3. What is the value of A1? A1 is equal to minus 83.33. Minus 83.33. These are the B and A value. What you have to do now? Now, sigma C inner. We have to calculate sigma C inner. For the inner cylinder, sigma C at this location you have to calculate. Sigma C at this location. Sigma C at this location, you will get two sigma C's. One is for inner cylinder, one is for outer cylinder. So what is the equation to calculate the stringage elements? Delta R is equal to R2 by E within bracket sigma C outer plus sigma C inner. So this is the equation. What is sigma C out? So now we are calculating sigma C inner. Sigma C inner means sigma inner, the inner cylinder sigma C at this location. So now sigma C inner for inner cylinder, that is equal to B by X square plus A. B by X square plus A. What is B? Minus 5.3 divided by 125. We want to calculate it 125. 125 square minus 83. Minus 83. So what will be the value? The value will be, it is 136. It is 136 compressive. It is minus 136, right? Minus 136 newton per millimeter square. This is sigma C inner. And now we have to go for the outer cylinder. Now we go to for the outer cylinder. What are the boundary conditions for outer cylinder? when you take out outer cylinder, the inner diameter is subjected to a junction pressure. So when R is equal to 125, pressure sigma R is equal to how much? 30. This is one boundary condition. What is another boundary condition? When R is equal to 150, sigma C is equal to 0. So for this boundary condition, the equation is, now let us take, this is B2. 30 divided by B2, 125 square minus A2. This is equation 1. Equation 2 is 0 is equal to B2 divided by 150 square minus A2. Now solving equation 1 and 2, you will get B is equal to one value and A is equal to another value. Right? What is B? What is A? Here B is equal to 1534. 1534090. What is the value of A? A2 is equal to 68. Is equal to 68. Now we have to calculate sigma C outer. Sigma for outer cylinder. For the outer cylinder, sigma C at this location, at the junction. So sigma C outer. Sigma C outer. That is equal to 1534090 divided by 125 square at the junction plus 68. So this will give 166 Newton per millimeter square. I already told you we have to add delta R1 plus delta RI plus delta R2. Here we are getting it sigma C inner as a compressive. If you put minus value in this equation, it will give the difference. Delta RI minus delta R out. But we don't want difference. We want sum. So this minus sign you should not substitute here. While substituting this equation, you should not take the minus. If you take minus, it will become difference. I want to add both. See here, I want to add delta R naught and delta RI. Both I have to add. If you put minus, it will give the difference. So you don't put the minus, you put plus. So here you substitute. What is the value of R2? 125. What is the value of Young's modulus? It is 2 × 10⁵. 2 × 10⁵ within bracket 10⁵. This is 136. Outer is 166. 166 plus 136. It will give the value of delta R. It will give the value of delta R. It is equal to 0.189 millimeter. So what is the meaning? If delta R1 plus delta RI plus delta R0 is equal to 0.189 millimeters, then the junction pressure will be 30. Junction pressure will be 30. If you want to produce, in the previous problem, from the junction pressure, we calculated the stress distribution. But if you want to produce a junction pressure, what should be the value of delta RI plus delta R out? Delta RI plus delta O, outside diameter. So this, the expansion of the inner cylinder plus compression of the outer cylinder. This will be the value. If you give this much amount, then the junction pressure will be 30 Newton per millimeter square. So this is a way we have to solve this problem, right?